Hello and welcome to another vlog. So today I'm so excited. I've just decided to do some chocolate dipped covered strawberries. How amazing does that sound? So I've got my strawberries, I've washed and dried them already. I've got some lovely chocolate ready to be melted. And just as a little extra added bonus, I thought I'd do some little toppings as well. So I've got some pink gold sugar, some hundreds and thousands, some gold sugar, and I've also got some honeycomb. How lovely does that sound? Okay, so I've got my chocolate chips, and just here I have my strawberries, as you can see under there. I've got my kettle of hot water, and I'm going to pour it underneath because I'm using a double a Bain-Marie, a double boiler here. So I'm just going to make sure that the water doesn't touch the bowl, but still allows the heat to melt the chocolate. Okay, I'm just going to pour in my water. I'm using milk chocolate, and the ideal temperature for milk chocolate to melt it is between 110 and 115 degrees. Any higher than that and it will burn the chocolate. I think I will add. Okay, so now my chocolate has reached the correct temperature. I've popped some parchment on a baking tray, and as you can see underneath, I've dotted some chocolate underneath so just that it will hold the parchment in place so it won't move once I dip the strawberries. So let's get to it. You have to make sure your strawberries are completely dry. I dried them one strawberry at a time. Now, if you do decide to put them on a parchment, you will get a foot. If you don't want the foot, then you really need to use skewers. And there you go. That's the first one done. So the first one I'm going to do is a plain one, and this is what will create the foot once I pop that down. Look how glossy and shiny. It's almost a shame to pop it down. You have to do it when it's wet so that the sugar sort of sticks to it. Also, try and get off as much excess chocolate as you can. Sometimes it's just not always that easy. Try some honeycomb. Now I'll do hundreds and thousands. These look so good. I can't wait to eat them. Unfortunately, that one got a bit knocked about, but the rest of them, look at them, they look so good. So as you can see, the first row is just chocolate. The second row is rose gold sugar. The third row is pink shimmer sugar. The back row there is honeycomb, crushed up honeycomb. And then here at the side is hundreds and thousands. I can't wait to chow down on these. Look at Mark. How does that taste?
Oh, that's really good. It's like melted melted Maltesers.
Wow.
That's really nice. I'm finishing.
Now, we really should wait until they are set, but...
Who waits? And I also, as I get to sample, I get to choose one and I pick one of the biggest win. Just because I like to. Shall I try?
Yes, go ahead.
Mmm. Do you know that? I like the chocolate not set. Because it sort of adds to it.
Yeah.
It's a really good quality chocolate, that, actually.
It's almost like it came from a chocolate fountain.
Mmm. Look, there's not much left. That was really good. Mmm.
The rest are going in the fridge, but that was for you to try. It wasn't quite set, but still.
Mmm. No, I can see the added thing of putting it in the fridge, but they're nice either way. Delicious.
Yeah. All right, well, we hope you like this vlog.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm still eating. We'll see you in the next one. Take care, look after yourselves, and remember, you're never too old to have fun. Bye for now.
Bye for now.